Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to create an online quote, bid, or estimate in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. As a business owner, you may need to provide your customers with a quote for products and/or services that they are considering purchasing from you. Creating a quote in Xero will allow you to easily keep track of the status and with just a few clicks create an invoice, a bill, or purchase order from a quote. While Xero uses the term quote by default, you can change this to bid or estimate depending on your preference. In this lesson, we will walk through the steps of how to create an online quote, how to create invoices, purchase orders and bills from quotes, and how to make changes or delete a quote altogether. From the Xero dashboard, we want to go ahead and click on Accounts and select Sales, and then click on the New button and select Quote. Let's discuss the information that is required to complete a quote, starting with the Customer field. You can either type the customer name or select it from the drop-down that you want to create the quote for. If you have not set the customer up yet, you can do so by clicking the New Contact option here. The Date field will automatically populate with today's date. You can change this by clicking the drop-down and selecting the appropriate date here. Expiration field. This field will automatically populate with the default date that you set up for quotes. If the expiration date differs from the default, you can change it by clicking the drop-down and selecting the appropriate expiration date here. The quote number field will automatically populate with the next available quote number to ensure that duplicate quotes are not created. The reference number field is an optional field. You can enter any information in this field about the quote, such as a purchase order number. Theme. The branding theme that you selected during the invoice setup will automatically populate in this field. You want to go ahead and click the drop down if you need to change it. You can add a title and a summary to a quote by simply clicking this option here and then typing the title information and the summary information in these respective fields. So here's what our title would look like if we decided to do that, and also what an example summary would look like here. From the drop-down, you can select the item that you're providing a quote for. If you have not set up the item in Xero, you can do so by clicking Add Item here. Be sure to watch our How to Set Up and Manage Products and Services tutorial to learn how to set up and manage your inventory items. You can click here to access this lesson. The description field will automatically populate based on the item that you selected in the previous field. You do have the ability to modify the description if you need to by typing directly in this field. For the quantity field, be sure to enter the appropriate number of items that the quote is for, if it's products. For services, be sure to enter a quantity of 1. The unit price field will auto-populate based on the unit price that was set up for the item. If the item was set up with the unit price of 0, then you can simply type the unit price directly in this field here. Discount. If applicable, enter the discount that you would like to apply to the quote. If you would like to set certain customers up with a standard discount, you can do so in the invoice setup. Click here to access this lesson. In the account field, you can select the appropriate account that you would like to track the income for each item sold from the drop-down. Be sure to watch our How to Set Up Accounts tutorial to learn more about the chart of accounts. You can click here to access this lesson. Tax rate. In the How to Set Up Sales Tax Rate lesson, we showed you how to set up a default tax rate that is applicable to most of the products and services that you sell. You can click here to access this lesson. Tracking categories. Xero allows you to set up tracking categories to see how different areas of your business are performing. For example, departments, locations, or regions. In this example, we have region, as a tracking category. So you can select the appropriate region from the dropdown here. Amounts are. From the dropdown, you can select the amounts, whether they should be tax exclusive or no tax. To learn more about tax amounts, check out our organization and financial tutorial. You can click here to access this lesson. The amount field will automatically be calculated by Xero by taking the quantity times the unit price. So there's no need to do anything in this field. If you need to add additional lines to the quote, you can do so by clicking this Add a New Line button here. And then the Terms field. Indicate the terms of the quote in this field. You can set this information up automatically to appear on each quote. We showed you how to do this in the invoice setup tutorial. Click here to access this lesson. Once you've completed all the necessary fields of the quote, you have the option of either saving the quote or sending it to your customer via email. Let's talk about the save options first. Save as draft. This option will save your quote and allow you to close out of the screen. The Save and Continue Editing option will allow you to save your quote before you are done completing the quote. You can save periodically so that you don't lose any information. Save and Add Another. This option will save your quote as a draft and open up a new blank quote for you to complete. This can be convenient if you have several quotes that you need to enter for multiple customers or the same customer. To proceed with emailing the quote to your customer, you want to go ahead and click the Send button. Once you do that, you will see the email template pop up here. And the fields that you want to complete are the To field here. In this field, it will automatically populate with the email address that was set up for the customer. If you would like to send the quote to more than one person, you simply have to put a semicolon here and then enter the next person's email address. Xero will automatically populate the subject to line here. However, you can feel free to modify it as you see fit. Here is the standard messaging in the body of the email that will go out to your customer. Please note that there will be a link for your customer to click on to view the quote online. Once they view the quote online, they can accept, decline, they can send you a question or a comment, or they can print the quote. And here is the link that will appear. Last but not least, at the very bottom here, you have a box that says, "Send me a copy." You can actually have Xero copy you on the email that is sent to your customer. Once you've completed all the necessary fields, you want to go ahead and click Send, and the email will go out to your customer along with a copy of the quote. Xero makes it pretty easy to make modifications to quotes that you've created. So you want to go ahead and return back to the quotes by going to the Account section and selecting Sales. And once you're on this screen, you want to scroll down to where you see quotes. Xero groups quotes into four categories here: draft, sent, accepted, and expired. All quotes that appear in the draft status are quotes that you have created but have not sent to customers yet. All quotes that have been sent are quotes that you have sent to customers and you are awaiting a response from your customer. All accepted quotes in this group are quotes that have been approved by your customers. And finally, expired are all the quotes that have reached their expiration date and were not approved before the date came. So we'll go ahead and click on the group that our quote falls into. And then to select the quote, you can simply just click on the customer name and the quote will display. And if you click the options button in the upper right hand corner, you're going to see we've got a total of 5 different options that we have to choose from for the quote. So let's start with mark as accepted. If you don't send quotes via email to your customers, but instead you mail or fax them, once your customer approves the quote, You will need to manually mark the quote as accepted in this screen to update the status. Mark as declined. By the same token, if you mail or fax a customer a quote and they decline it, you will need to manually mark the quote as declined in this screen to update the status. If you just need to make some changes to the quote based on your customer's request, you can easily revise a quote by clicking this button and making the necessary changes. Copy to allows you to save time because Xero will take the contents of an existing quote and create a new quote, an invoice, a purchase order, or a bill using the same information. If we click the copy to here, here are the options we have. So the first one is to copy the contents to a new quote. So again, if you need to send a quote for the same exact products and services to another customer, you can select this option and Xero will copy the information from an existing quote to a new quote. From there, you can make any changes to the customer or any other information as you see fit. Invoice. Once your customer has accepted a quote, you can select this option and Xero will copy all of the information from the quote to an invoice so that you can easily bill your customer. Purchase order. If you realize that you need to place an order for products that you have an existing quote for, select this option to copy the information from the quote to the purchase order so that you can promptly place an order to your supplier. And then finally, a bill. You can create a bill in Xero by copying items from an existing quote to a bill that you need to pay. Once you have made your selection, you can go ahead and click the Create Draft button so that Xero can create the document for you in a draft status. The last option that you have here for quotes is to delete a quote. If you want to delete a quote, you can easily do that by selecting this option. Since quotes are considered a non-financial transaction, deleting a quote will have no impact on your financial statements. That wraps up the lesson on how to create an online quote, bid, or estimate in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.